What's going on, guys? Beastly Gamer here. I wanted to send a quick shout out to Jesse Williams, the amazing producer who produced this nice tune you guys hear running in the background. He's making a lot of music, and I'm using it all on my page. I want you guys to go on over and check him out. There will be a link in the description for you guys to hear some of the amazing stuff this guy's produced. Please let him know that the Beastly Gamer sent you. The footage you guys see is me playing Call of Duty Ghosts. I did go a little beast mode on these hoes. I got 26 and 3 on them, so I hope you guys enjoy that, me going a little ham on them. Now, I talked to you guys 2 videos ago about Newegg.com, their Easter sale, and pretty much all the money you can save right now if you were to take advantage of that sale. They got games for sale for the PS3, the Wii, the Xbox 360, the PS4, and the Xbox One on that website. And it appears that that's not the only place where you can take advantage of a great spring sale. If you're an Xbox Live Gold subscriber, there is a lot of great savings going on right now, and I think that you guys should pretty much take advantage of them. Xbox 360 spring sale is on, but it doesn't feature the best bargain on the Xbox Live right now. This article is on GameSpot.com. There's an Xbox 360 spring sale going on, only the best deal on Xbox Live right now has nothing to do with Microsoft's Xbox 360 spring sale. Instead, if you're an Xbox Live Gold subscriber, you can pick up Batman Arkham Asylum and Batman Arkham City for $4.99 apiece as part of a weekly deal. Both are certainly worth the punt if you're yet to play them and you enjoy having fun. So these two games are part of Xbox Live Gold's weekly sale. Has nothing to do with the springtime sale that Xbox Live has going on. So I do implore you, if you have not had a chance to play the Batman Arkham games, to get them for $5 a piece is a huge value. Go ahead and give them a shot. Highlights of the actual less good Xbox 360 spring sale are Borderlands 2. You can get Borderlands 2 for $6.99. The Assassin's Creed 4 Black Flag Season Pass for $13.39 and Saints Row for $14.99. There's also discounts on a chunk of DLC, including the Saints Row 4 DLC, Dead Island DLC, Dishonored DLC, Borderlands 2, Skyrim DLC, Fallout 3, and New Vegas DLC, Thief DLC, and State of Decay DLC. The discounts range from 33% to 75% off, and these deals are valid until April 21st, Microsoft adds. What do I think about this? I don't have anything negative to say about that. If you're going to do well, if you're going to do something for the consumer, I'm 100% for it, and I congratulate Microsoft for making that kind of move. Sony, I guess, is kind of forcing their hand. They got to do something nice for their consumers, because there's a lot of public outcry. So way to go, Microsoft. Nothing bad to say there. Moving on, this is also on GameSpot.com. It appears that the developers of Tom Clancy's Division don't mind postponing the game, delaying the game, doing whatever it takes if the game's not right. And they're learning this from watching the developers over at Watch Dogs, the creators of that game, how they pushed the game back till May 2014 to make sure that the quality of the game is right. Now, some people think this is a bad idea. A lot of people, I want it now. I want the game now. I'm not one of the people who has to have the game now. I don't mind waiting for 6 months. I don't mind waiting for a year if it means the product is going to be right. You know, I would have waited for an extra year for an experience like The Last of Us. They could have just sat on that. But the point is, the experience has to be right. And the fact that these developers don't mind us waiting a little while to get our hands on it, I'm all for it. This article is on GameSpot.com. The Division developer says Watch Dogs' delay sent an important message. If there's a choice between time and quality, then quality will win, says the Division developer, but will the game come out in 2014? Ubisoft studio Massive Entertainment, the primary studio behind the upcoming PS4 and Xbox One shooter, The Division has labeled the decision to delay the release of Watch Dogs till May 2014 as a tremendously important one. It's tremendously important for us as a developer studio to know that the owner and publisher are ready to take that hit, and delaying Watch Dogs was a massive hit. I think their shares fell 25% on the day it was announced that it was being delayed, says Massive Entertainment boss Dave Caulfield. I think that's how you pronounce his name, I'm sorry if I'm wrong. It takes so much courage to live through that day and still think that it was a good decision. So for us in the development team, that's an important message that ultimately the management will back up the goals that we have, which is the game has to be great. That's ultimately the end goal, and then it's a million times better when it's on time. Caulfield continued, But if there is a choice between time and quality, then quality will win. And I don't see anything wrong with that. I think if you're a real gamer and you're upset that a game's being delayed, you might be a little immature. I mean, if the cycle is going on for 3 or 4 years, like The Last Guardian or something, I can kind of understand you getting a little upset. But pushing a game back 6 months, 8 months, these kind of things happen. But will The Division see a delay of its own? Earlier this year, a massive entertainment employee was reported to have branded the idea of The Division launching in 2014 as laughable. You guys let me know what you think about this. I think if it does get delayed, it's just the way the cookie crumbles. I hope you guys enjoyed this footage of me whooping ass. I'm the Beastly Gamer, and I'll see you guys next time.